in the city of New York, there's been a dramatic increase, 25, maybe 30%. In fact, just January 1st, a few blocks from here, on 48th Street, two swastikas were painted at someone's home. And this is a community of Holocaust survivors. You can't even imagine. It's hard to imagine for someone who went through the Holocaust, lost so many family members, to see that swastika on a wall. And then the following day, at a synagogue in Midwood, a few minutes away from here, a swastika was painted, synagogue, senior citizen center, frequented by Holocaust survivors with the, you see the message on the bottom. You know, who is doing this? What is this all about? In 2008, to have to confront this kind of ugliness, this kind of hate, this kind of maliciousness is something that, for me personally, a mother who went to Auschwitz in 1944 and lost her mother in the gas chambers that very same day, and brothers and sisters, and to have to deal with this 60 years later, that kind of hate. When Eric Adams and I stood together at Columbia University, after one of the many incidents of nooses being, you know, someone thinking it's maybe a sad, horrible joke to leave it outside the door of a professor at Columbia or anywhere else, we stood together to say, this is not about the black community being in pain. The swastika is not about the Jewish community being in pain. The swastika, the noose, it's the same in terms of the hate that people have in their heart. And that was the beginning. In fact, a woman by the name of Vera, who happens to be black, emailed me a wonderful note thanking me for speaking out and saying in her note to me, in her email, I mean, the relationships are wonderful. The people that are standing with me, many of them are friends that go back 30 years, and we are, believe me, totally on the same line in terms of what's right and what's wrong. But this is something broader. This is about when there is hate in one community, we stand together. If it's in the black community, I'm going if you call me, and the rest of the group. If it happens in the Jewish community, it's not about Simcha Felder and Dov Hikind standing together to speak out. It's about all of us together. And we get together as many people as possible, and we stand together. We love the city, and we will work together. That's the message. Plain and simple. Many have asked, what else are we going to do? Well, we are going to sit down, and we are going to figure out things that we can do. People from one community coming to the other community at public forums, educational seminars, introduce all kinds of experiences that, believe me, most people have not shared. As a public official, I get an opportunity to share a lot of things. But the average person out there, they're is always a need for more understanding. There's always a need for more sensitivity. And that's what this is all about, and I'm so proud of the fact that literally every person I spoke to for this conference, everybody said yes. Everybody was excited. Everybody was totally, well, I want to be part of this. And that is, and that speaks volumes of the elected officials in our great city, of tolerance, of living together in this great city. This is the greatest city in the greatest country on the greatest known planet, and we got the greatest people that are united together to send a uniform message across this great globe that this city is the welcoming mat for the greatest race alive, and that's the human race. And Dov, I thank you so much for embracing me.
We have been called by the historian Arthur Hertzberg, a comradeship of excluded peoples, and that's what we are. And therefore, today, when I came into this room, I felt there is a special relationship that we all share. And I have to speak personally just for one moment. You know, back in the ancient days, when you had Pharaoh and you had the Jewish people. So Pharaoh, great leader, also great leader of the Jews, Joseph. Joseph had an idea how to save the civilization from famine, from extinction. And Pharaoh had the resources. He had the grain. He had the produce. They got together, and they saved a generation. I think what the Honorable Assemblyman Dov Hikind has done today has begun a new chapter in understanding and working together and in saving civilization from its further decline and downfall. My grandfather was a man who was political. He was also a great rabbi. And there he had an adversarial relationship with the mayor, Mayor Gittes, back in Europe. And they got along together, but they were also a little bit afraid of each other. On the night when my grandfather knew either he gets out of Europe or else he's going to be extinct, Mayor Gittes sent him a letter that he better appear in the middle of the public square at night. No one's to know about it. He's not to bring anyone with him. Well, he was afraid to come that night, and he didn't know what he should do. But the mayor asked him to come, and out of respect for his office, he did show up. The mayor said to him, "Rabbi, I despise you, but I can't bear to see you leave." And with that, he gave him a visa for his exit. So I have warm feelings when I come here today. The great Dr. Martin Luther King said, "My people were brought to America in chains. Your people were brought here to escape the chains of Europe. Our unity is born out of a common struggle for centuries, not to rid ourselves of temporary bondage, but to make oppression of any people by others an impossibility."
Management. This is not about having a press conference at the scene of a noose or at the scene of a swastika. This is about showing the world that blacks and Jews get together and we work together, period, so that you form a relationship. It's a relationship of love, not the relationship of tragedy or crisis. And that is true, that, you know, a husband and wife, you know, when things are bad, they have to be able to be there for each other. But the real point is to be there for each other, or, you know, when times are good. And that's the point. Today's press conference, and I thank Assemblyman Hikind for the vision to understand that we should not wait for another terrible event, but rather state to the world that we're here for each other all the time. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.